بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I welcome you to another episode of our series As-Safarat al-Kiram, where we try to be in the company of the holy angels by learning how to recite the Quran properly. I am your host Abu Ammar Yasir Qadi. In our previous episode we were discussing the history of the preservation of the Quran. And we had mentioned that by the time that the Prophet ﷺ passed away, the entire Quran had been written down but in scattered form. So the question arises, how did the Quran first receive its compilation? When was the Quran first compiled between two covers? And the response to this was that in the 12th year of the Hijrah, there was a battle that occurred known as the Battle of Yamama. And in this battle, over 70 Huffaz, 70 memorizers of the Quran, were martyred. So when this occurred, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he went to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, the Khalifa, and he told him, Oh Abu Bakr, I think that you should compile the entire Quran in one book before so many Huffaz die, before so many of the memorizers pass away. At first Abu Bakr was hesitant, but eventually he listened to Umar's advice and they both decided to choose Zayd ibn Thabit to be in charge of the compilation. Now they chose Zayd for many reasons. Firstly, because he was the primary secretary, the primary scribe of the Prophet ﷺ, who used to recite the Quran, who used to write the Quran. Secondly, Zayd was a young man, so his memory was much stronger than those of other people. Thirdly, Zayd himself had memorized the entire Quran. He was a hafiz of the Quran. And fourthly, Zayd was of the people who was present at the time when the Prophet ﷺ recited the Quran to Jibreel in its entirety. So when the Prophet ﷺ recited the Quran for the last time, from Fatiha to Nas, Zayd was sitting there in front of him, present, so he was the primary and perfect person for this job. So Zayd radiallahu anhu set about collecting the Quran and compiling it for the first time from Surah Al-Fatiha to Surah Al-Nas in one book. Now he could have done this from his own memory, he was a hafiz. He could have sat down and wrote and written the entire Quran from memory. But in order to ensure its proper preservation, he required two other huffaz to come forth who had memorized it directly from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he also required that one scribe who had written that verse in the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam come and show him that particular ayah, that particular surah, so that he could add it in the proper place, even though he could have done this all himself, but only to ensure, to authenticate, to verify that this was really the Quran the way that it had been written in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So within the space of 2.5 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's death, the Quran had been compiled for the first time in one book from Surah Fatiha to Surah Nas. Realize this is not the first time the Quran was written. The Quran had been written down entirely in the lifetime of the Prophet ﷺ. The only difference was that it was finally compiled in one book. Previously it had been scattered in many different books. Now it had been compiled in one book and they called it the Mus'haf, meaning the collection of loose papers. And to this day we call our Qur'ans Mus'hafs because of that. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was in his khilafah, was the first khalifa to compile the Qur'an into one book. And this occurred when almost all of the companions were still alive. Almost all of the major companions, hardly 2.5 years after the death of the Prophet ﷺ, under the direct supervision of the very people who wrote the Qur'an, who memorized it and who heard it from the Prophet ﷺ. Can any other religious book claim such authenticity? Verily, Allah is the one who has revealed the Qur'an and He is the one who will preserve it. Returning to our rules of Tajweed, we were discussing the rules of Nun, Sakinah and Tanween. And we have now finally arrived at the last rule. We discussed three rules before this. We have now arrived at the last rule. And that is the rule of ikhfa, or suppressing or hiding. And in order to help you memorize this, I have chosen a picture of an oyster with a pearl hidden inside it. Okay? So the ikhfa hides something. It is something, it is a treasure that is hidden. Okay? This is what the meaning of ikhfa is. Is that you suppress it or you hide it. Now what is, we said what is the ikhfa means to hide, but what do you hide? You suppress or hide the sound of the noon, sakina or tanween along with a ghunna. So you suppress it or you hide it. You don't pronounce it clearly as a noon, rather you suppress it. What do you suppress it behind? You suppress it behind the remaining letters of the alphabet. What do I mean by remaining letters? What letters have we discussed before? The letters of idhar, the letters of idgham, and the letters of iqlab. Okay, or the letter, excuse me, of iqlab. So we discussed the six letters of idhar, the one letter of iqlab and the six letters of idgham. So how many letters are left of the Arabic alphabet? 15 letters are left of ikhfa. We have 15 letters of ikhfa, and these are the remaining letters that we have not discussed for the nun, sakinah, or tanween. And these are the sad, the dal, the tha, the kaf, the jim, the sheen, the qaf, the sin, the zi, the zai, the fa, the ta, the dal, ta, da, and dha. Now you don't have to memorize these as long as you memorize what's previous. If you've memorized the letters of idgham and the letters of ikhfa and the letter of iqlab, you can just say everything else is ikhfa. Okay, so the remaining letters, the remaining 15 letters of the Arabic alphabet, they follow the ruling of ikhfa if they occur after a nun sakina or tanween. Okay, so what is the ruling again? The ruling is that the nun sakina or tanween will be hidden behind one of these letters, depending on what comes after it. And there will be a ghunnah. Let us take some examples. We can't take examples for all the letters. There's too many of them. Let us take some examples of ikhfa. We have the first one. The noon sakina followed by as-sa, and also a tanween followed by as-sa. So we say man sabara. Notice it's not man. You see, if we had said man, where would the ikhfa be? Where would the hiding be? It's not a clear noon. This is the point of ikhfa. It is hidden behind the letter after it. Likewise, amalan saliha. عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. You hide the noon behind the sad and you have a ghunnah. The next example, we have a noon sakinah followed by a seen. فَلَا تَنْسَى. Now sometimes it will sound very close to a noon. It depends on the letter after it. But it's never a clear noon. Okay? Like us over here. رَجُلًا سَلَمًا. رَجُلًا سَلَمًا. You have a tanween followed by a seen, so it will be ikhfa, and there will be a ghunna. Now we said the ghunna is the sound that comes from
nose.
The nose. There is one important fact. Any time a ghunna occurs in the Quran, any time, it is always, if you like, half a second long. We call it in Arabic two harakas. Okay, a haraka, and we'll define this later on in more detail, is the time it takes to open a finger from a closed fist. You have a fist closed, you open up a finger, this is a haraka. So the ghunna is two harakas. Okay, this is the unit that is used by the scholars of tajweed to define a time. Obviously, they didn't have clocks back. They didn't have stopwatches. So they said you have a closed fist, you open up your finger, and that is one haraka. Okay, so this is one haraka, this is two harakas. So this is the length of the ghunna. We have a noon sakin here followed by a dal. What will be the ruling here? Once again, it will be ikhfa. So we say junda. Like was over here, qinwanudaniya. So we have a tanween followed by a dal, and over here we have a noon sakina followed by a ta. Likewise, a tanween followed by a ta. Same ruling applies to ikhfa. An tahira, baldatun tayyibah. بلدة طيبة. We have once again tanween followed by a ta. Okay, now one of you brothers tries. Try from this example. أنزلنا. Okay, very good. And this one.
أو متاع زبد.
Okay, so you have a tanween followed by a za. Once again, there will be a ikhfa. Okay, you try now.
ينفقون.
Very good. You have the noon sakina followed by a fa. Once again, there will be ikhfa. Over here.
خالدا فيها.
You have a tanween followed by a fa, so this will be the ruling of ikhfa. Okay, your turn, akhi.
كنتم.
Okay, كنتم. The noon sakina followed by a ta. Once again, ikhfa. Over here.
جنات تجري.
Once again, there is tanween followed by a ta. Okay, next example.
مندود.
Okay, once again you have a noon sakina followed by Allah, so there will be an ikhfa because it is of the letters of ikhfa. Over here.
عذابا ضعفا.
Okay, so you have a tanween followed by a dad, so once again there will be an ikhfa. And one final example, ينظرون. You have a noon followed by a dha, once again there will be ikhfa. ظلا ظليلا. Once again there's an ikhfa because of tanween followed by a dha. Okay, I will recite Surah Al-Insan for you if you follow along with me, and we will try to follow along, and I will try to point out to you where the letters occur. In fact, let us do a review of all of the rulings of Nun, Sakinah, and Tanween. So we'll try to do a review of all of these rulings so that we can implement them when we recite the Quran. Surah Al-Insan is the 76th surah in the Quran, and is also a very early revelation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا.
Okay, what's the first ruling now? Very good. Al-insan. What is the ruling?
Ikhfa.
Ikhfa, because it is a noon sakin followed by?
A seen.
Okay. The second ruling that we've done? Hinum. Hinum min adah. Okay. There's what?
Idgham with ghunna.
Idgham with ghunna. Why? There's a tanween?
The tanween is followed by?
Followed by? A meme. So there will be idgham with ghunna. Okay. Lam yakun.
Shay'an. Here we have ikhfa.
We have ikhfa.
Followed by sheen.
Because there's noon sakin followed by a sheen. Shay'am madhkura. What is this ruling now?
Idgham with ghunna.
Idgham with ghunna. Because.
Is followed by meem.
Exactly. The tanween is followed
the
by.
Of idgham.
Exactly. It's followed by a meem with the letters of idgham.
Inna khalaqna al-insana min nutfatin amshajin nabtalihi faj'alnahu samian basira.
Okay.
Again,
al-insan. Al-insan, same thing. Okay. Min nutfa. Idgham with ghunna. You have noon sakina followed by a noon. Nutfatin amshaj. Clarity, idhar, because you have a tanween followed by
a
hamza, and hamza is letters of idhar. Amsha jin nabitali.
Idgham
with ghunna. Faj'alnahu sami'an basira.
Clear
iqlab. Okay, so we have an iqlab over here. Yeah. And notice the small meme we on top of the mushaf, on top of the letter here,
yes,
to show you the iqlab. Okay, suppose we hadn't stopped at basira and we moved on. Basiran. What do we do now then?
Clarity is hard.
Clarity, because it is a hamza in the next letter.
And we have qalqala in the word khalaqana.
Very good, yes. We have a qalqala in the word khalaqana. We have another qalqala as well.
Yes.
Nutfa. Very good. We have two qalqalas. What level of qalqala?
The weakest
level of qalqala. Khalaqana and nutfa. Nutfa, the lowest level of qalqala. Moving on now.
إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا.
Okay, we have over here السَّبِيلَ. What is the ruling we took of السَّبِيلَ? Who can remember this?
Solar lamb.
It's a solar letter, therefore the lamb will be dropped. Okay,
yes.
And we go السَّبِيلَ. We don't say هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ. Okay, إِمَّا شَاكِرًا. How about the tanween followed by a?
Idgham
with ghunna, because it's followed by awa. Wa imma kafuran. If we had gone on kafuran inna, it would be idhar.
Inna a'tadna lil kafirin salasila wa aghlala wa sa'ira.
Aghlala wa sa'ira. What is the ruling on? Idgham with ghunna, because there's a tanween followed by a wow.
Innal abrara yashrabuna min ka'sin kana mizajuha kafura.
Okay, yashrabuna min ka's.
Yes.
What's the ruling here? Ikhfa, because there's a noon second followed by
kaf.
Likewise, ka'sin kana.
Yes.
Same ruling exact. Tanween followed by a kaf. Okay. Notice abrara. Notice the alif was what? Heavy. Because
ra is
heavy in this case. Whereas mizajuha, the alif was what?
Light.
Okay. Again, this is very important. Many people say abrara, but that's the alif would be light and the ra would be light. It's abrara. Others might say kafura, making the alif heavy, but it's kafura because the kaf is of the letters that are light. Okay. This brings us to the conclusion of another episode. inshallah, will continue the rules of tajweed, will continue to strive to be, inshallah, of the company of the holy angels of Safaratul Kiram. Please tune in next time. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.